Hi there, I'm Sean Doman. If you're a lawyer, paralegal, or legal assistant, stay tuned. In this short course preview, I'll be discussing what elements should be in place for a digital filing system in legal practice. The first and most important element of my office filing system is the use of standardized naming conventions. To control and manage files and folders, I use specific conventions which distinguish internal use files from external use files. Whereas internal use files are for use only by the firm and its staff, external use files are documents that may be presented to people outside of the firm, such as clients, colleagues, and other professionals. For example, if I draft a letter to a person named Sam Lee on August 6, 2020, I name the file 2020-08-06 Letter to Sam Lee. Because this is simply a letter that I'm drafting, it's clearly for internal use only. Similarly, if I receive documents from a client by mail on November 10th, 2020, I use the internal naming convention to create a folder with a name like 2020-11-10 Docs from Client and save the scanned files into that folder. Conversely, the external use naming convention looks like this. If I finalize my letter to Sam Lee a few days later on August 8th, 2020, and want to prepare it to be sent by email, I name it Sean Doman-Letter to Sam Lee open bracket 08-aug-2020 close bracket. Although these file names may not look like much at first glance, they're designed to achieve specific goals. For internal use file names, the numerical year, month, date format organizes files chronologically, and the lowercase letters take the guesswork out of how files should be named. This produces a uniform standard of how internal use files look and differentiates them from external use files. Further, lowercase names can be typed faster than mixed case or all caps names, and the descriptive names suggest file contents on their face. For example, just by looking at the name of this file, 2020-10-22 Employment Contract, I know that this file contains an employment contract that was originally created on October 22, 2020, and it's for internal use only, which means that it may be a draft or maybe the final version that was eventually used. If I want to determine if it is the final draft, I'll need to dig deeper. For example, I see a file entitled 2020-10-27 Signed Employment Contract, which suggests to me that this file is a final version that was signed 5 days after the original version was made. To confirm, I need to open the file and see what it contains. When used for folders, the numerical year, month, day format ensures that folders will appear chronologically. When digital documents are received by email from correspondents, the files can be placed in these folders without them being renamed. For example, if on July 11th, 2020, a client sent me a copy of a scanned document that is named Tax Documents, I'd store the file in a folder named 2020-07-11 Docs from Client. When storing files in a folder in this way, I can simply leave the files with the name that the sender gave them. Before I send digital files to recipients by email, I would stage them using a similar system. For example, if I sent a letter to a lawyer named Kelly Brown on October 23rd, 2020, I'd first place the documents in a folder entitled 2020-10-23 Docs to Kelly Brown. By taking this step, I have a place to collect my documents and ensure that they're complete and correct before sending them. Further, if I see the folder in the future, its name will suggest that the contents were sent to Kelly Brown on October 23rd, 2020. If I want to confirm how the documents were sent, for example, if they were sent by regular mail, email, or fax, I can look in the letter itself and it should contain a line that says either sent by regular mail, sent by email, or sent by fax. The letter in the folder is also named using the external use convention so that if it's sent to Kelly Brown as an attachment to an email, it'll be named in a professional and presentable way. By using mixed case letters for external use files, they have a polished look, which differentiates them from internal use files. Further, the numerical day, month, year format provides a useful reference date. When used consistently in an office, this naming system makes it easy for everyone to follow the same rules and maintain a consistent organizational structure. There's no need for anyone to consider which words to capitalize or pause and think when renaming files. Everyone already knows the format that's to be used and will name and file documents accordingly. When people see files and folders which use the internal and external use conventions, they'll know what it means intuitively. If everyone commits to the system, it provides stability and utility. However, if some people follow the system and some don't, The result will be a disorganized and unreliable system. If you wish to implement my system on an office-wide level, be aware that some coaching and reinforcement may be required. However, once everyone's on the same page, more time can be spent doing productive work, and less time will be spent reinventing the wheel, searching for files, and figuring out how to organize information. Thank you for watching. I hope that I was able to provide you with some useful information that you can put into use today. If you liked this video and found it to be helpful, please comment below, leave a like, and subscribe to this channel. For more information about me and the full version of this course, please use the below link to visit me at my website.